Hello guys, welcome to my channel SMB Institute. Today we are going to learn project management terminologies. So before start this lecture, I will suggest you don't skip the video, see this video till end so you will get a lots of knowledge. I request you please subscribe my channel and also press the bell icon so you can get notification of every latest videos. So here I open the document. So these project management terminologies are very important and every project planning engineer is need to know about these basic terminologies, because these are very important as an interview point of view, because when we are going for job as a planner, these type of questions are usually asked by the interviewer. So first of all, we discussed what is project. It is a work in which the end of result is unique and duration is temporary. So here, what is project? I give result is very unique and duration is temporary. It means at one time project start and in specific time the project will be ended. So what is BOQ? As you know, in my previous lectures I have discussed many time about BOQ. BOQ is bill of quantity. As you know, when we are working on activities, work quantum is come from BOQ document. So when you are working as a planning engineer, you have very concerned with BOQ. So what is IFC? It is a type of drawing. So an activity, as you know, in our previous lectures we have a very common discussion on activities. It is the lowest level of our project. So this type of question are asked usually in interviews. So activity is lowest level of our project. What is WBS? As you know, in our first lecture we define and explain WBS, work breakdown structure of our project into deliverables component to manage our project effectively. So before when we are going to plan our project, we divide our project in WBS or WBS structures, so we can manage our project effectively. Float. As you know, float is basically flexibility. Amount of time with an activity can be delayed without delay the project end date. So float basically the flexibility in any activity. It means if we delay the activity, it doesn't affect on our project. But the critical activities have zero float. So that's why if we delay the critical activities, so our project will be delayed. Lag. Progress is below or less according to our requirement is known as lag. It is not good sign. Dear students, lag is very bad sign in our project, because when there is some problems during our working and we are not going according to our plan, so there is lag sign in our project. It means we are, our progress is below or less to our requirement. It means we are below the baseline. So during this lecture I remember you guys, please try to note down these things in your notebook, so it will be helpful in your future. So please write down these things on your notebook. So what is progress? In our execution phase we have very we use this formula many times. Progress equal to work divided by total work, the amount of work which we have done. So this formula in our execution phase we use many times. So write down this formula on your notebook. Predecessor, successor. As you know, we have two types of activities. Predecessors, the type of activity which is independent of other work, other activity. It means predecessor activity is independent. Successor, the type of activity which is independent another activity. It means successor is depend on another activity. We use here example like our house walls and house roof. House roof is dependent on wall. It means until the wall work doesn't start, we are not able to make roof of our house. So what is wattage? Wattage is equal to value of component divided by value of project. So in our execution phase, we have used this formula many times, activity codes, to classify or categorize our project of center information. Activity codes, as you know, in our previous lectures, we have made activity codes, and also we show these activities by using group and sort by option. So activity codes are very important. It does not belong to any mathematical calculation. The only purpose of activity codes is to classify or categorize our project on certain information. So what is S-curve? The graph of cumulative against time interval is known as S-curve. In our execution phase, we use S-curve very efficiently to execute our progress. The graph of cumulative value against time interval is known as S-curve. It means these S-curves are used to measure progress, data date or cutoff date. During execution phase, site engineer take data from specific date. This data is known as data date. Overlapping planning. By changing the relationship of activity, we save calendar days. This technique is known as overlapping planning. As you know, anytime we can change the relationship of our activities. So by changing the relationship of activities, we are able to save our calendar days. This technique is known as overlapping. So dear student, in this lecture, we briefly discuss about the project planning terminologies. So if you have any question about this lecture, don't forget to question in comment box. I am on the other side to answer your question. So please, I request you like this video, share and also subscribe my channel. Please press the bell icon so you will get the notification of every latest videos. Many thanks.